problem, they're out of square. Just slightly, but everything's gotta be perfect. So basically what's going on is like, well, I machine one side and flip it over and do the other side. Somehow things aren't lining up perfectly, and it's not working out for me. So it's basically, what we're gonna do is make a fixture where we could, basically what we'll do is we'll saw a piece that's longer. Like, this is too long right here, right? It's just a raw saw cut. And what we'll do is we'll put a stop in the vise and come down, drill our four holes. See, we have these four holes right here. So we'll drill our four holes, right? And then what we'll do is we'll have tap holes right here. So this will go down and actually screw down to the fixture. So we'll actually be holding on to the fixture. And then we'll come in and cut these sides, and it's gonna be perfectly square. So it's gonna make things like way freaking easier. So basically we're gonna screw it down right here, screw it down, and then when you come in, cut across here.
Profile the sides.
Yeah, so the main thing, it has to be perfectly square. All right, so one of the manufacturing problems when it happened is when we use the vise, we cut one side, flip it over to the other side, it's not perfectly square. And I mean, this is going on a 3D printer / CNC machine. I think that'll work good.
Looks good to me.
I'm happy. So the best tip for tapping is to make sure you don't put your tap in a bind. Especially with these little bitty taps. This is a Helm 3. It
makes fragile.
Last thing you want to do is break a tap into the fixture. Tight. I'm afraid to get any tighter because it might snap the tap in there. Also, when you start, you want to tap it straight. It will be perfectly perpendicular. See, it's kind of easy right here. I don't have to worry about breaking it right now. But once it starts getting deep, it gets harder and harder. It gets in the bind and snaps the head off. Tap. You can feel it too. You want it to be like really easy to twist. And I do a little technique. I call it tech tapping. basically it starts to get a little tight, like you feel it takes a little bit more pressure to turn it, then I go backwards, just like I was petty drilling. Then I come back in, and that helps. That'll kind of like, that'll kind of evacuate some of the shaving. But eventually you have to take it all the way out and blow off the shaving. And see, I put like a little yellow mark right there. That's how I know how deep it goes.
Exactly. I've had to remeasure.